Hello friends, myself Rashmin sir, teaching English to the students of 9th to 12th standard in English medium. Students, today we will take a very important topic for you all guys, that is indirect speech. Remember, in every standard, 9th standard, 10th standard, 11th standard and 12th standard, this particular question holds an important place in the question paper. Because it carries 4 marks. Okay, in 100 marks paper, it is of 4 marks. And since you have been doing it for so many years, most of the things are clear for you. Then also, I would like to just refresh your memories about certain things in this particular topic. So, first of all, see, normally we students are asked to convert a paragraph of direct speech into indirect speech. Okay, so first of all, let us find out what is direct speech. So here the definition is given. You are not supposed to remember the definition. Just you must have the knowledge. So what is the definition? When somebody's spoken words are quoted exactly as they are, it is called direct speech. So somebody said something to us, we are repeating the same words in front of someone without any changes. Then we can say it is the sentence of direct speech. For example, he said to her, I have already submitted my project. Now, when you relate this same thing to someone, you will use these words only. Okay, you won't make any changes in that. So that is the sentence of direct speech. Now, what is indirect speech? So just opposite of it. When somebody's spoken words are reported with necessary changes, and not as they are, then it is called indirect speech. So in this given sentences, okay, give spoken words of someone, we make necessary changes. Okay, then it becomes the sentence of indirect speech. So if you take this sentence, he said to her, I have already submitted my project. So its indirect would be like this. He told her that he had already submitted his project. So remember, here my became his, here I became he, present perfect tense have already submitted, became, had already submitted, reporting verb said to, became told, and both the parts of the direct speech, reporting verb and reported speech are connected with the conjunction that. Okay, now that's what we are going to study. A sentence of direct speech is divided into two parts. Which are those two parts? Reporting verb and reported speech. And whenever we do the indirect of any sentence, these two parts would be there. Okay. So whenever I say reporting verb RV or reported speech RS, you must understand what they mean. Look at the example. He said to his sister. Now that part is called reporting verb. And the spoken words, okay, quoted words of someone. My new job is quite comfortable than my previous job. So these words are spoken by he, so they are known as reported speech, and they are always given in the inverted, double inverted comma. Okay, so those few things you keep in mind. Now when you go for the indirect of any sentence, three major changes you are supposed to keep in mind. Which are those three changes? We will see here. There are three main changes to be kept in mind while converting dialogues into indirect speech. Dialogues means direct speech. Okay. First is what? Change in pronouns. So pronouns are of different cases. Okay. In each case, they are in different forms. So the entire table must be learnt by heart, and it's not that tough. Students, you almost know all these things. Just you must understand to differentiate between them. Okay. So first is you have subjective case. So here the pronoun are normally written at the place of subject. With that only the sentence begins. So I, we, you, he, she, it, they. These are the pronouns of subjective case. Then you have pronouns of objective case. Under objective case, you have me, us, you, him, her, it, them. Remember, these pronouns are written normally after the main verb of the sentence. Then you have possessive case. In possessive case, you have the pronouns like my, our, your, his, her, its, their. Okay. Then you have another type of possessive case that is called, for your understanding only, I have written over here, possessive case 2. So mine, ours, yours, his, hers, its, theirs. So here most of the pronouns will take s in the end. Okay, except mine. So my became mine. Now remember that the pronoun of a particular case is replaced with the other pronoun of the same case in indirect speech. Cross changes are wrong. They are not allowed. So if you want to replace I, so I will be replaced either with he or she. Okay, if you want to replace we you can replace with either we or they or you. So from the same case you can take any other pronoun which is suitable to the gender of that subject. But you cannot take any other pronoun from other cases for this particular case. So for I you cannot use him or her. For I you cannot use his or her. For I you cannot use mine or yours or his or hers. So I will be replaced only with the another pronoun from the same case. Similarly, in objective case also, me can be replaced with any other pronoun like him or her from the same case. In possessive case also, if the pronoun is given of the first possessive case, then another pronoun will take place of that pronoun. Okay? And in fourth also, the given pronoun will be replaced only by the other pronouns of the same case. So students, keep all those things in mind. If when you do I, when you convert I into me, that is normally done in passive voice. I ate a chocolate was eaten by me. But here it is not like that. Okay. So students, just keep in mind. Here the example is given for that purpose only. Look at the example. He said to her, I shall visit you tomorrow. Now here the pronouns are I and you. Now I refers to he and you refers to her. So accordingly the changes will take place in indirect speech. So said to will become told. So he told her that I became he. So I is replaced with he from the same case. Okay. That he would visit, you refers to her and you is at the place of object. So here for you referring to her, so that's why we have taken her over here, because it is at the place of object. So objective case pronoun should be used for that. And tomorrow will become the next day. So student, here pronouns are replaced from the same category. Just keep that thing in mind. Again, when you are given the names of someone, so you must identify whether the given name refers to a female gender or male gender. Okay, if it is female, then you'll have to use she. If it is male, then you'll have to use he. So here the example says, Pallavi said to Hitesh, I shall bring your book tomorrow. So here speaker is Pallavi. Okay, so I refers to Pallavi. When we change it into indirect speech, I will be replaced with she. Okay, and here your refers to Hitesh's, and Hitesh is he. So your will be replaced with his. Okay, so look at the indirect of the same sentence. Pallavi told Hitesh that she would bring his book the next day. Okay, tomorrow will become the next day. So here I think it is clear how the pronouns are replaced with the other pronouns of the same category. Okay, you don't have to take any other pronoun from the other categories. Now moving forward, we see the second type of changes. Second type of changes over here are the changes in time and place showing words. Now all these students you are supposed to mug up. You must learn them by heart. Okay, because in indirect speech, anywhere if you make a mistake, the entire sentence is wrong. So you will not get any marks for that. Okay, half marks are not given. In indirect speech also and in transformation also. Anywhere you are wrong, then entire sentence is wrong. So you lose the complete marks. You are not given half marks. So that's why all these changes are very necessary. Okay, in direct speech, suppose this is given, it will become that in indirect. Then these, that is the plural form of this, will become those. Then here will become there, today will become that day, tomorrow will become the next day, yesterday, the previous day, yato the day before, next week, next month or next year will become the following week, following month and following year. Last week and last month or last year will become the previous week, the previous month or the previous year. Then tonight will become that night, ago will become before, now will become then, thus will become so, and come will become go, but not always. Here come can become go only in certain cases. Okay, so students, that you'll have to keep in mind. You just don't go on saying that no sir, that day gave the changes, in that he had told that come will become go. Come becomes go, but not always. Okay, that I'll explain to you later on. So, and secondly, reverse changes are not allowed. Suppose that is given in the sentence of direct speech, it does not become this when you change it into indirect. So reverse changes are not possible. If that is given, you'll have to keep that only. If those is given, then you'll have to keep those only. You cannot change those into this. This will be changed into those. Here will be changed into there, but there will not become here. So reverse changes are not done. Just keep that thing in mind. For example, that will not become this. That will remain that only. Similarly, come does not always become go. Okay. So here, students, I have done just one example for you. When come becomes go and when come remains come only. Okay. So when you are doing the indirect of the sentence and you talk about the coming of someone, then come will remain come only. Okay, but when you talk of going through the adjective, through the verb come, then come will become go. Look at the example. He said to me, I shall come to your house today. Usne mujhe kaha, main tumhare ghar aaj aaunga. So he told me that he would come to my house today. Now he told me, and I am only doing the indirect. So here the sense becomes that he is going to come. He is coming to my house. So come will remain come only. Okay. But look at the next example. I said to her, I shall come to your house tomorrow. Now here I am telling her. Now same thing when you repeat or relate to someone later on. You can say this way. I told her that I would go to her house the next day. So yahan jaane ki baat hai. So जाने की बात है इसलिए कम का गो हुआ. बट इन द फर्स्ट एग्जाम्पल यू सी कम रिमेन्स कम ओनली बिकॉज देयर इट इज जस्ट अबाउट कमिंग. ओके, देन लुक एट द अनदर एग्जाम्पल स्टूडेंट्स. माई फादर सेड टू मी, आई हैव पेड योर फीस टूडे. ओके, सो माई फादर सेड टू विल बिकम टोल्ड. सो माई फादर टोल्ड मी दैट he had paid my fees that day. Today became that day. So here today changes into that day. Now next example. The teacher said to the students, you have to write the essay now only. So now also becomes then. So these examples I have written just for that purpose, so that you can understand ki how certain time and place showing words are changed when you go for the indirect of the sentence. Okay. Answer, you see, the teacher told the students that they had to write the essay then only. Now became then. Okay. Have to became had to. Okay. You became students. You became they over here. So pronoun they we used because it is referring to the students and students are in plural form. Okay. So that is the second type of changes, students. Kindly keep all those changes in mind. Otherwise, your entire sentence may be right, but because of that particular change which you are making wrong, entire sentence will be given wrong. Okay. Now we move on to the third type of changes, very important changes in indirect speech, and that is change in the tense of the reported speech. Okay, so remember, whatever the person speaks, he speaks in different tenses or he uses different auxiliaries. So they also undergo certain changes. Here, if the person is speaking in simple present tense, so how can you identify the person is speaking in simple present tense? So either original verb will be written or the verb will have S, ES or IES in the end. Then you can identify that the given sentence is in simple present tense. So it will become simple past tense. So go or goes, if it is given, then go or goes will become went. Similarly, in negative and interrogative, do and does are used in simple present tense. So that will become did. Okay. Now here important thing is, whenever you use do or does or did, the main verb is written in its original form. फिर यहाँ भी do does का did करते हो और go का went करते हो, वो नहीं चलेगा. Do does का did किया यानी वो past हो गया. Then you don't have to change go into went. Understood? So do not go या does not go will become did not go. Understood? Then you have simple past tense. Suppose in direct speech simple past tense is given. Simple past tense means the past form of the verb. What did is used. Here past form of the verb is went. So simple past tense changes into past perfect tense. So went will become had gone. Because in past perfect we use what? Had and third form of the verb. Similarly, if it is did not go, that also shows past tense. So that will become had not gone. Because had and third form we require and it is negative. So we will put not over there. So students, here you see, simple past tense becomes past perfect. Then you have present continuous tense. So present continuous tense, am or are or is plus verb ing. So that is present continuous tense. Am going, are going or is going. So that will become past continuous. In past continuous, instead of am or is, we use was or were. So was going, yeah, were going. Then past continuous tense, if it is given in direct speech, was going, yeah, were going, that will become had been going. So was and were should be replaced with had been. Going remains same. Then present perfect tense, have gone or has gone, that will become had gone. Okay, present perfect will become past perfect. Then present perfect continuous will become past perfect continuous. So in present perfect continuous we use have or has plus been plus verb ing. So that will become had been going. Okay. So have has is replaced with had, and then been going same. Then past perfect continuous, if it is given in direct speech, so there is no change. Okay, had been going, so no change, had been going, it will remain the same. Similarly, past perfect is given, there also no change, had gone will remain had gone. Then suppose the sentence has auxiliaries. Auxiliaries means may, can, could, should, must, would, all those are considered as auxiliaries. So suppose any auxiliary is there, suppose may, so may will become might, but the main verb will remain as it is. Go will remain go only. May go, might go, can go, could go, so can will become could. Okay, must go will become had to go. Okay, in place of must we will use had to, and go will remain same. Similarly, now important thing comes over here, students. We have not discussed so far in the above sentences, in above changes of the tense, simple future tense. So simple future tense comes over here. Okay, if it is shall go or will go, both will become would go. Just remember this. Shall ka bhi would hoga, will ka bhi would hoga. Okay, shall ka should nahi karte. Understood? Then if it is should, would or could go, so no changes, same, should, would, could go. Okay, and the other way, if you want to remember the changes of the tense, then you do this way. If MR is given, then you replace MR is with was were. You keep remaining things as it is, then tense will be changed. If was were is given, you replace them with had been, and remaining verb forms you keep as it is, so that also tense will be changed. If have has is given, you replace them with had. so then also the verb will be changed. Okay, so students, here important thing is, note all the above mentioned three changes must be learnt by heart by the students to convert direct into indirect speech correctly. Okay, if you don't learn all these changes by heart, definitely you will lose the marks, because from time and again you will go on making mistakes, and slight mistake in any sentence, the entire sentence is wrong. So students, all these three changes that I have shown in this video, kindly learn them by heart. You have still got plenty of time. Okay, your board exam will be next year, so till that time you have got plenty of time. Just learn these three basic changes by heart. So later on, when we go for the indirect of any sentence, all these changes will come. So just stay fine, stay fit, learn these changes well, and just do well in your studies. Thank you and have a nice day.